turn it down. Where's the donkey?
He's coming at number.
Can't start without him.
So, find you tonight. Okay. Volunteer.
I want the donkey.
That's the
Thank you, Boris. That was wonderful. Welcome to Christmas at the Manor. Here we are gathering with Daisy the donkey and Gertrude the geese and Sally the sheep and many more. My name is John Joseph Massendre. Welcome to the Manor. As we gather for worship and celebration, we acknowledge that we're on the traditional home of the Wendat, the Tinanate, also known as the Fatun, and the First Nations, collectively known as the Neutrals. We also gather upon the current home of the Mississaugas, and over generations, this territory has become home to many First Nations, Métis, Inuit, settler, and immigrant peoples. We strive to seek justice and walk in right relation with all peoples on Turtle Island, may we be connected to heartbeat, the spirit is one. O come, all ye faithful. Also welcome Shelley Neal on the piano, and we welcome also Zach Gabriel and his father Ron Gabriel as co-narrator of our lovely evening. And tonight we say that 'twas the night before Christmas, and all through the square not a creature was stirring, not even a bear. The wings were hung by the angels with care, in hopes that Gabriel would soon be there. The children and parents with hats on their heads, with visions of snuggles and warmth in their beds. When up from the Manor Road there rose such a clatter, the red rocket sprang forth to bring people to the matter. Away to the pageant and race here in a flash, donning scarf and mittens to be mantle and sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave luster to the evening objects below, when what to our wondering eyes should appear but Mary and Joseph and many winged dears, with a little old staff of shepherds so quick, come calling and caring to people they pick. More rapid than eagles the courses they came, and whistled and shouted and called them by name. To the manor, to the birth, a nativity come to the wall. Now dash all here, and dash to the pageant and all. God be with you.
And also with you.
And we say, gracious God of this night, guide us to see. Hope is a star that shines in the night, leading us on till the morning is bright. When God is a child, there's joy in our song. The last shall be first, and the weak shall be strong, and none shall be afraid. Gracious God, guide us to see. Tonight is the night of dreams, and we have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, and every hill and mountain shall be made low, and the rough places shall be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. And all shall be, see it together. Touch the star. Amen.
The story of Mary. A cold night coming we had of it, just the worst time of the year for a journey, and such a long journey. The way deep, the weather sharp, the very dead of winter. This is the time of year that we hold again, the special night where we dust off the pages and remember it all began long ago, across a great sea and then another. The scroll is reopened to recall the promise of ages past. It was a year to be remembered at the quiet place of honor, when the words of the story come alive. In the sixth month, the prophet spoke. See now, I am sending a messenger among you to bring news, one of who carries the line of David, called Mary of Nazareth. An angel, the messengers who stand beside us, the ones we so often hear about, the winged beings of the night sky, this angel is our old friend Gabriel, sent from God unto the region of Galilee to the city of Nazareth. He was sent to speak about love and the promise of old. He was sent to proclaim a great hope to a maiden espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the woman's name was Mary. Gabriel came to her and said, "Hail, you are the highly favored. The Lord is with you. Blessed art you amongst women." And when she saw him, her heart froze with trouble at the words and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And Gabriel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you bring forward a son, and shall call his name Jesus. His wonder will exceed the farthest horizons, and he shall be called the Child of Promise, the Sacred Son of the Highest, the Offspring of Love. He shall be kissed by the four winds of wisdom and bring light over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom shall reach from the farthest mountain to the distant seas." Then Mary, in a state of confusion, said unto the angel, "How shall this be?" And the angel answered and said unto her, "The Holy Spirit shall come upon you. Your baby will be a child of heaven, for with God nothing shall be impossible. Aim at heaven and you will have the earth thrown in." And the angel departed from her. And Mary said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord of love, be it unto me according to thy word that this shall be come to pass." And Mary left to ponder these matters.
What child is this? Joseph, on the sideline, the center stage, wearing his mantle of courage and love. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, and before they came together, she was found with child by the Holy Spirit. And Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, he was perplexed. But while the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and saying, "Joseph, son of David, fear not to take Mary for your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit, and she shall bring forth a son, and she shall call him Jesus. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, what was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a promise will come to pass. And the angel departed. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took him into his wife. And the time came for the two to take hold of the hand of love, and asking in the certainty of midnight to embrace the footsteps of Bethlehem. And Joseph went to get Mary. The little drummer boy.
Thank you.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that the entire world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone into their own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And at night we go to the ancient inn, where the child in the frost is furled. We follow the field where all souls meet at the end of the world. And so it was that while they were there in Bethlehem, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. The inn was so strange, so familiar, and yet so inviting. What was it about this place in the fractured cold of the night? Love was born in the humble hamlet. Then wisely is my soul elated that strife should vanish and battle cease. I'm poor and of low estate, the mother of the Prince of Peace. Joy rises in me like a summer morn. Peace, peace on earth, the Prince of Peace is born.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem. Out of the hills the shepherds lay, wakeful that never a lamb might stray. Humble and clean of heart were they, thus it was given them to hear, marvelous harping, strange and clear, and thus was given them to see, heralds of nativity. Shepherds, the keepers of the watch, fearless while watching, facing lions and wolves and bears, and reading the night sky, following the old star patterns as compass to guide in cold night. There they were in the same country, these same shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill toward all people. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let it come to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said again, go, let us go unto Bethlehem now, to the place of birth, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us. And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Among the oxen I see glory in the stable grow, which will oxes dullness might as they give oxes strength, and among them asses stubborn eye as they, I see my savior where I look for hay, and so my beast-like folly learn all at least the patience of a beast, and among the sheep I like sheep have strayed, I watch the manger where the Lord is laid. Oh, that my buying nature would win thence some woolly innocence. Oh, come, all ye faithful.
Magi, the ageless wise ones, advisors to kings and queens, seers of the night sky, guided by the star, they made their quest. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judea, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again that I may come and bring him homage." When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. Never we know what is in sleet and in snow, the place where the great fires are, that the midst of the world is a raging mirth, and the heart of the earth a star. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with great joy, and they came unto the house. They saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
We Three Kings.
We Three Kings.
And the angels arrived and said, glory to God in the highest, and peace and goodwill to all people. Mary's boy child. Times when stepping into a long journey causes us to draw from the heart of great courage as the inner depths of our being. And there are times when we risk these great steps and feel the Godhead in each footfall that we make. And there are times when the pace of life speaks to the ancient way. And there are times when the courage of love is born in the walk, where the bullfire birth brushes across our hearts. And there are times when the grandmother and grandfather are awakened, and the people that walked in darkness have seen a great light, and they that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation and increased to joy, the joy before thee according to the joy in the harvest. And as of all the rejoice with the divide the spoil, for unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Now the increase of the government and peace shall have no end, and upon the throne of David, upon its kingdom, to order it, to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth and forevermore. We have heard the children say, gentle children whom we love, long ago on Christmas Day came a message from above. Sing, choirs of angels. At Manor Road, we support many things. We support the food bank in Thorncliffe. We support the Roehampton Shelter. We support all the programs at Massey Center and refugees in Syria. We take this time now to welcome and receive our offering as we sing the first Noel. Thank you. Let us pray. We thank you for the gifts that we receive, the gifts of this night, the gifts of stories, the gifts of sheep and donkeys, and the gifts of joy in a child's heart. And may we now pray as Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Silent night. Merry Christmas to each other. Merry Christmas now. Just greet one another and say Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Okay. And we sing joy to the world. Wish you a Merry Christmas. Let's sing. Never we know, but in sleet and snow, the place where the great fires are. The midst of us, the earth is raging mirth, and the heart of the earth a star. God bless us, everyone. Now we have Boris on the trumpet. Thank you, everyone. Thank Mary and Joseph and everyone singing. And remember, December 24th at 4 o'clock, we come back to sing carols here at the Manor. And Christmas Day as well at 10:30. So do say hello to Daisy the donkey and Gertrude the geese and Sammy the sheep. And thank you, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Off all the hydrants.
Yeah.